Hello, I am Dr. Santosha. In this video, we will talk about cables under concentrated loads. The one which we can see here, a typical traffic lights being supported by cables. And these traffic lights is acting as a concentrated loads. How the cable tension can be evaluated? Let's see in this particular video. First of all, we have to understand what are the basic properties, important properties of a cable. Suppose there is a case of a traffic light supported by cables. The first property we can say that cables are considered to be perfectly flexible. There is no flexural stiffness and it is inextensible. Whatsoever load is applied, there can't be any bending moment in it. It is only considered to transfer only even tension. So the cables are flexible, they do not resist any shear force or any bending moment, and the cables are subjected to only axial tension. Even there is no compression cannot be possible in case of cable, and it is always acting tangential to the cable at any point along the length. This is specifically for the curved path. So what we understand from these points is that the cable can only take tension and there is no shear force, no bending moment in a cable. And normally the weight of a cable is neglected, yes, but there are cases in if it is very heavy cable, then only the weight is considered, otherwise the weight is not considered in the analysis, self weight of the cable. We should understand the behavior of a cable under the application of load. A cable gets deflected in a funicular shape. A funicular shape is a shape like, suppose if there is a cable and if I apply only one point load, then it will take a shape like this. If I apply two loads, then it will take automatically the shape like this. If I apply, for example, three loads, then the shape taken by cable is like this. And a case in which we are going, if I apply uniformly distributed load, then it will take a perfect shape of a parabola. So in this particular video, we'll talk about the cable subjected to concentrated load like this. Let's take a simple case. In the engineering mechanics, statics, we have already seen this kind of problem, but just for completeness, let us solve this particular problem. Determine the tensions in cable AB, BC and CD necessary to support 100 Newton and 150 Newton traffic lights at B and C respectively. Also find the angle theta. So this is a typical condition given, a very practical condition. So as we know, we have to solve this problem by drawing the free body diagram at point B and C. When we draw free body diagram, always we should remember that when we want to draw free body diagram at any point, just show the Cartesian axis x and y, and then this B to C will be termed as everything, even if it is a traffic light, but in a free body diagram it will be considered as 100 Newton force only. Even if there is a cable, but we will show that only there is a in cable there is only one force possible, that is tension, and tension we show away from the joint, pulling the joint. So this will be known as BA, this will be known as BC, tension BC, tension BA. These angle is given as 15, and when we draw this Cartesian axis, automatically this is 90, this is 90, this is 90. If this is 50, this is 90 minus 15. If this is 15, then it is 90 minus 15 equal to 75. So this is a free body diagram of B, and similarly we can plot the free body diagram of C. This is the common member BC, so the tension BC will be common in both the free body diagram, as you can see. So here again, this 150 Newton traffic light will be like this. This tension TBC, this is TCD, this is theta, it is given, and when we draw the Cartesian axis, this is 90 90 90. Obviously this is going to be 90 minus theta. So let us apply the Lames theorem, which we know very well. When we apply Lames theorem to point B, we know the Lames theorem is that any force upon sine of angle between the other two forces. The ratio of force upon sine of angle between the other two forces remains constant. That means if I take force as TBA and the sine of opposite angle is 90, sine 90 is equal to 100 upon sine of opposite angle between the other two forces is 90 plus 75, that is 165. So 100 upon sine 165 is equal to TBC upon sine of this angle. Now that angle is 105. So this is how we can apply Lamy's theorem. And TBA and TBC are the unknown, and we have the two equation. This term is known to us. So TBA, when we want to find, take sine 90 here and evaluate this, so we get TBA equal to 386.37. similarly, if you want to find TBC, take sine 105 here and get the answer as 373.20 newton. Now when we apply Lamy's theorem at point C, then this is how we will write our equation. TBC divided by sine of the angle between the other two forces, meaning this force. As you can clearly see here, the angle is 90 plus theta, sine of 90 plus theta, 150 divided by sine of this angle. Now this angle can be taken as total sine of 180 minus theta. So this is 180 minus theta, sine of 180 minus theta, and this TCD upon sine 90. We know sine 90 is 1. So we know sine of 90 plus theta is the cos theta, and sine of 180 minus theta is sine theta. So we can rewrite this TBC, we know from the previous step 373.2, and this 150. So unknowns are theta and TCD. Now if we sine 180 minus theta is sine theta, and sine 90 plus theta is cos theta, and when we take sine theta upon cos theta, it will become tan theta, and we can take this 373.2 in the denominator here. So we get tan theta equal to 150 by 373.2, and from that we can always take inverse, tan inverse, and get theta equal to 21.9 degrees. So we got over the first unknown, theta. And also now, if we suppose we want to find tension in TCD, TCD is equal to, this is sine 91, so 150 upon sine of theta, and we get it as 402.16 newton. So this is how a simple problem can be solved by applying Lamy's theorem. Let us solve one more problem, in which this is the data, and then there is a cable ABCD, and as you can see, it's a funicular diagram and they are not in the same level. So in such problem, the data is given as for the cable, find the maximum tension and sag y. So what is this y distance? It is to be found here. It is at B point, but this A point is 4 meters below the B point, and these are the loads applied. So let us assume that there is a vertical reaction at A, we call it VA. There is vertical reaction at B, we call it VB. There is a horizontal thrust H, and H, they are going to be constant, same, because sigma fx equal to 0. So if we apply the first equilibrium condition, sigma fy equal to 0, we get VA plus VB minus 60 minus 80 equal to 0, and we get VA plus VB equal to 140 kilonewton. Now in order to find this VA, VB, H and Y, okay, we have to use one by one different condition. So this already we have got VA plus VB 140, we will use it. Now we will take sigma m at point A0. So while by doing it, we'll see that V and H will pass through point A, so they will not cause any moment. So when we take moment at A0, so what we get VB into 52, which is anti-clockwise, so minus, plus 80 into 32, plus 60 into 12, and this H will also cause a moment, 4 meter it is above, so it is causing clockwise. H into 4 should be 0. So from this we get one equation in terms of VB and H. We say 13 VB minus H equal to 820, dividing all terms by 4. So we get this relationship number 1. When we take moment at D0, this point, when we take moment at D0 from right hand side, consider the right hand side, we say minus VB into 20 plus H into 12 should be 0. So we get another relationship between VB and H. So minus 5 Vb plus 3H equal to 0. Now in order to solve this equation 1 and 2, we have to multiply equation 1 by 3 in order to cancel the term H. So equation 1 multiplied by 3 will become like this. And when we add equation 1A and 2, when we add equation 1a and 2, 3h will get cancelled, and this will become 34 vb, and it will become 2460. So we get vb equal to 72.35 kilonewton. So once we get vb, we can get va by deducting from 140, because va plus vb is 140. So va is 140 minus this, so 67.65. now we know that minus 5 Vb plus 3H equal to 0. Since we know Vb, we can get H from this, and it comes out to be 120.58 kilonewton. Now the next thing we need to find the Yc. So we need to find out the Yc, and we need to also find the maximum tension. We have to see that out of Va and Vb, Vb is higher and Va is only H, 120.58. so when we take square root of Vb square plus H square is going to be Tb, and that is going to be Tmax. Maximum tension Tb is equal to under root of Vb square plus H square, that is going to be Tmax. In order to find this sag y, we have to take moment at C, and we have to consider the left hand side. So it is Va, now we know it, Va into 12, which is clockwise, minus 8 h into how much is this? This is y and this is 4, so this is going to be y minus 4, should be 0. There are only two forces. When we substitute Va equal to 67.65 12, H 120.58, and Y minus 4. When we solve this for Y, we get Y equal to 10.73 meter. So this is how we can solve the problem. Let's take one more problem. A cable of horizontal span 28 meter is to be used to support 6 equal loads of 50 kilonewton, each at 4 meter spacing. The central deep of the cable is limited to 2 meter. Find the length of the cable required and its sectional area for if the safe tensile stress is 750 newton per mm square. So this is a problem like this, in which there are 6 point loads are attached like this, concentrated loads, and the central deep is maximum 2 meter. These loads are spaced at 4 meter each, and total span is 28 meter. What we need to find out is first of all the length of cable and the cross-sectional area of the cable, meaning we have to design the cable, in short. Okay, so this is problem is a symmetric loading, in which the entire problem is symmetric about the central vertical axis. So Va and Vb can be easily found out. Va plus Vb equal to 6 loads of 50, that is 300 kilonewton, and by symmetry Va and Vb have to be same, that is equal to half of this, that is 150 kilonewton. When we get Va Vb equal to 150 kilonewton, and then we have to take moment at F0. Since we know this 2 meter, we take moment at this point, and considering the right hand side, we say Vb into 12, minus Vb into 12, plus 15 to 8, plus 15 to 4, minus H into 2, plus H into 2, should be 0. And when we solve, we'll keep Vb as 150, only unknown is H, and we get H equal to 600 kilonewton. When we know these values of H, V, and Vb, we know the maximum tension will be at the support, either at A and B, because they are the same, TA and TB, they are the same, and the maximum tension is root of Va square plus H square, root of 150 square plus 600 square is 618.46 kilonewton. That is the maximum tension. We know from the mechanics that no stress is given to us 750 newton per mm square, and maximum force we know tension is 618.46 kilonewton. So we know the stress is force upon area. So area, since we want to find it, area is force upon stress, force converted in the newton divided by the stress, and we get 824.62 mm². This is the cross-sectional area of the cable required, which is one of the question. In order to find the length of the cable, we should know first what is this H1. So in order to find H1, we have to take moment at C equal to 0. At this point we have to take moment 0 and consider the left hand side. Then we say that minus H into H1, that is anticlockwise, plus VA into 4 should be 0. We already have H and VA. When we substitute, we get H1 as 1 meter. So we get this sag as 1 meter. Similarly, we can find H2 when we take a moment at point D, and again we consider the left hand side. So this time it is H into H2, that is minus VA into, it is 8, plus N50 into 4, like this minus. Everything is known except H2, and we get H2 as 1.67 meter. So once we get these as 1 meter, 1.67, 2, 2, 1.67, and 1, we can find the length of cable as 2 times 4 square plus H1 square. So this is the first cable, 2 times because it is a symmetric. So we'll take these 3 chord and then we'll add this 4 meter because that is a horizontal. So 4 square plus H1 square, that is this length, plus 4 square. Now this much is H2 minus H1 whole square. So that is this 4 square plus H2 minus H1 whole square, plus this one is 4 square plus 2 minus H2 whole square plus 4 meter. So when we substitute all, we get the length of cable as 24.384 meter. That is the second answer. Thank you very much.